In this tutorial, we'll be looking at putting together a file that's suitable for variable data printing. What is variable data printing? With variable data printing, design elements, such as text, graphics, and images, can be changed from one printed piece to the next by taking information from a database or external file and inserting this into the design during the print process. For example, we can take a team logo design and add the names and player numbers of all the individual players in the team. Or if we're printing company ID cards, we can take the name, job title, and employee number from an external spreadsheet and add the employee ID photo from a folder of images. The advantage of VDP is that data is pulled into the print job without having to stop or slow down the printing process, or having to create custom graphic designs for each individual. There are various RIP software packages on the market that can utilize VDP files, but in our tutorial today, we're going to be using Roland's VersaWorks Jewel to demonstrate the process. We're going to start by creating a file that we can send to a large format printer plotter, and that is then going to be able to pull data from external files and place these in our design to create custom graphics. So let's get started with the design. Here I have my logo, and I'm going to use these shapes here to create a common outline by choosing Object, Shaping, Boundary. I can now delete the individual shapes, except for the inner circle here, where I'm going to add some text. Let's fill our logo background with colour. Because I'm going to be outputting this through a Roland printer, I'm just going to open up the Roland Colour System library and work with that. The next step is to designate fields or containers where our data is going to be placed. But at this point, I need to explain how VDP works. I'm going to create two fields as data containers. One for the player's name and one for the player's number. In addition to this, I'm going to place a cut line around the whole logo. In order to place data in these containers, I'm going to create a custom palette and rename each color. The name of each color needs to correspond with the name of the data column in our data spreadsheet. For variable data printing to work, each name must be VDP in capitals followed by an underscore. So the names of the columns in our spreadsheet are VDP underscore name and VDP underscore team number. Because I'm going to be sending my job to a Roland large format printer, I'm going to start by opening the Roland VersaWorks palette. To do this, I open the Color Palette Manager and then the Roland palette. I'm now going to save this palette under a new name, Swindon Tigers. Next, I'm going to edit and rename the existing spot colours. I'm going to keep the cut contour colour as it is, as I want my logos to be printed and then cut out. Then I'm going to delete the remaining spot colours, as I want to use colours that give me a better contrast with my design. You can actually use any colour for this. It doesn't have to be spot colour, as long as you convert it to a spot colour before renaming. Next, I need to create individual spot colours for each data container in my design. So I'm going to choose Add Color and choose a spot color from the Roland Color System palette. I'm going to choose a blue color for the player's name field and then click OK. Now I rename this color exactly the same as the column title in the spreadsheet, in this case, VDP underscore name. I'll choose a yellow color for the player number and again give this color the name of the column in the spreadsheet, VDP underscore team number. We can now see the new name change on the palette. The next step is to apply the new outline colors to our data fields in our design. Select the object and right-click on the color swatch to apply the outline color. In the status bar, we can see the new outline colors. What will happen when we send the file to the printer is as follows. When the printer sees the area defined by a specific color name, it's going to pull the data from the corresponding spreadsheet column and insert it into the data field in the design. Now that we are finished with creating the data fields, we're ready to export our design as an EPS or PDF file. It's important that the spot colors are not converted because the specific color names will be used to tell the RIP software where to grab the data. So I'm going to leave this box unchecked. We're now finished for the moment in CorelDRAW, so let's now move over to Roland VersaWorks Jewel and bring in our EPS file. I'm now going to bring my file into Roland VersaWorks Jewel by adding it to the job queue. Under the Document Information, Special Items, I can see this spreadsheet icon, which is indicating that my file also includes variable data. At the moment though, we can't actually see the two fields we created for importing the data. So the next thing we need to do is to go into the Settings and make some adjustments. All we can see at the moment is where the cut contour line is and where the logo is going to be cut out. To see the variable data fields, we need to click on the variable data icon. It's worth mentioning at this point that for VDP to work, your RIP software will need to be able to support variable data printing. If you can't see this option, it's worth checking with your printer manufacturer if a software upgrade is possible. On the Variable Data tab, I now need to check this box to enable this feature. Our next step is to open up the spreadsheet that I'm going to be capturing the data from. We can now see the list of data and the column names. What is great is that through the Attributes panel, we can make some last-minute adjustments if necessary. I just need to select a name from the list, for example, and I can change the name, the font size, alignment, etc., or add an effect. So if I want to add a drop shadow, for example, I just click on the icon, choose a color for my text or shadow, and adjust the shadow offset. I can even choose a different color as a background for my text. But for the moment, I don't need a background color or shadow, so I'm just going to undo these. If I want to apply the same changes to each name, I just need to select the whole column instead of a single name. Here we have a case of one name being a lot longer than the others. If I check the auto-sizing option, the font size will adjust automatically so that every name, no matter how long, fits nicely into the allocated space. I could not only change the data here, but I could also adjust the data fields themselves by grabbing the handles and resizing them, for example. Let's now go ahead and adjust the team number column. Now that I'm done here, I'm going to go ahead and click on the Layout tab. We can now see that we've brought in all our variable data and we can see each of the logos that we want to print and cut. In this design, I should actually have white text on a black background. So why aren't I seeing my text? Well, by default, the variable data panel displays the text in black. So all we need to do is format the whole column, changing the text from black to white. In our next example, we're going to print out some ID cards, and for this we're going to need 4 data fields. One each for the name, job title, employee number, and the employee's photo. I started by opening up the Roland VersaWorks color palette again and saving it under a new name as the Global Network Palette. I then deleted the colors I didn't need and added spot colors from the Roland Color System palette, which I then renamed to match the names of the columns in my data spreadsheet. In this case, the column names are VDP underscore name, VDP underscore title, VDP underscore image, VDP underscore employer number, and I also have my cut contour color. So let's just apply these outline colors, export the file as an EPS, and bring this into Roland VersaWorks Joule. I've brought the file into Roland VersaWorks Joule, and again we can see the small spreadsheet icon that indicates that we are dealing with a file that contains variable data. I'm now going to click on Settings and then on the Variable Data icon. I enable the Variable Data Printing feature and open the CSV file. I'm now quickly going to adjust the 3 text columns. We have several options for rotating and aligning images. We can also choose how best to fit the image to the data frame. When we're happy with the layout and formatting, we can click on the layout icon to see the final result. In our final example today, we're going to create a VDP file for a sheet of numbered inventory stickers. Our column heading is called VDP part number, and all I need to do is create a list of consecutive numbers. Holding down the Control key, I drag down from the first number to create my list. All I need to do now is save this as a CSV file. Here we have our company inventory sticker, and I've already created my custom palette, which contains a color called VDP part number, as well as the cut contour color. Let's assign the colors to the outlines. All that's left to do is to export the design as an EPS file. I hope that this tutorial has shown just how easy it is to create variable data files in CorelDRAW. And if your customer provides you with a spreadsheet of data, all that is left for you to do is to rename the column headings and create spot colors in CorelDRAW with corresponding names. Thank you for watching.